robots and rigorous procurement process.
I think that was not enough.
Even then, from the very onset, we faced stiff opposition from within and without.
In the face of all this, we remain resolute.
As if that was not enough.
I'm not sure you have a current election. Because for the first time in the history of our country,
we have a current election. Today, we can all be proud of a brand new biometric voter register that reflects the individuals who are eligible to vote. With determination and focus, we were able to prepare a register that recorded 17,027,000.
The election did not witness issues of missing names, misplacement of polling stations.
641 eligible voters. From registration to election day were laid bare to the citizenry.
In addition,
through the Let the Citizen Know initiative, we provided every citizen who cared to know relevant timely information on all our processes.
We can be proud that
today, citizens have access to information on the number of registrants on the voters' roll, the number of registered male and female voters, the number of youth, the number of first-time voters, and the number of persons with disabilities who are on the electoral roll. In addition, today we can all be proud that as Ghanaians we went to the polls and cast our votes peacefully.
We can be proud that the usual hustle and struggle at polling stations, the long queues, and the overcrowding were all absent. We might be proud that in spite of the COVID-19 pandemic, we all went to the polls with our safety guarantees as a result of the stringent safety protocols employed by the Commission. And to crown it all, we must be proud of the fact that we have been able to declare the results some 48 hours after the election day. With hard work, focus, determination, and above all, God's help, we can do all things. Yes, we can. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is important to emphasize that we have achieved our successes as a result of the collective efforts of the entire team. And here I'm referring to our commission members, our directors, our regional directors, our deputy directors, our deputy regional directors, our district electoral officers, our administrative works and mechanical staff. We have all worked round the clock to achieve our goals. To all our team members, I say Aiko, I salute you all. We certainly could not have succeeded without you, and I commend you all highly. To the dear citizens of our country, we thank you for believing in us and for walking this journey with us. Your constructive feedback has helped strengthen our processes and our work and has left us in a much better place than when we started. To our media partners, we say thank you. You have been our gateway to the citizenry and have helped bring the commission to the doorstep of citizens. We could not have achieved our mandate without you, and we are grateful for your partnership over the last few months. To the civil society organizations that have believed in us and shared recommendations for well thought out research and analysis, we acknowledge and commend you highly, and we say